In this Viewfinder video tutorial, we're going to cover the basics of Blender by modelling a coffee mug. For a more in-depth version of this tutorial, see issue 4 of the New Zealand Viewfinder magazine. Start by changing to orthographic view with keypad 5, then to side view with keypad 3. Press X to delete the default cube. Left click in the centre of the screen to position the 3D cursor. Press Shift A, then add a circle. Change the number of vertices down to 20. Because you're looking at the circle from its side, all you'll see is a line. To look, change to top view with keypad 7. Press Tab to change to edit mode, then keypad 3 to return to side view. Roll the mouse wheel up to zoom in, then drag the screen down with the center mouse button. Press A, then A again. Press E to extrude, move the mouse up. Press Z to lock to the Z axis. Press Ctrl R, then roll the mouse wheel up 4 clicks. Press A to deselect all. Hit P for box select and select the bottom vertices. Hit E to extrude, then escape. Then tilt the object forward using the center mouse button. Hit Alt M, then choose At Center from the pop-up. Press A to deselect all. Then box select the top vertices. Hit E, then Z. Move the mouse up a little. Press S to scale up a small amount. Then hit E, then Z, and extrude the same amount again. Hit E, then escape. Then tilt the cup forward with the center mouse button. Hit S, then 0.9. Change back to side view with keypad 3. Hit E, then Z, then drag down to almost the bottom of the mug. Hit E, escape, then Alt M, and choose At Center. Press these buttons to limit the selection to visible, and change to face select mode. Hold Shift and click on these two faces. Change to front view with keypad 1. Hit E to extrude and type 0.3. Then extrude again, this time 0.2. Tip the view up, then select this face. Extrude and pull it down about halfway. Hit X and choose faces from the pop-up. Then select this face also and delete it. This will make the handle more seamless. Change back to front view and vertex selection. Turn off the selection limiter. Hit A, then A again. Then box select the bottom of the extruded part of the handle. Drag this section down till it sits on top of the vertices below. Box select these 8 vertices. Click on Remove Doubles, then change the merge limit to around 0.07. Hit A to select all, and click on Recalculate under Normals on the tool shelf. Tab back into Edit Mode, click on the spanner, then on Add Modifier. Choose Subdivision Surface from the menu and change the view to 2. Click on Smooth under Shading on the tool shelf. Tab back into Edit Mode and turn on the Selection Limiter. Add a ring cut in this section just under the lip and drag it up into the lip. This will make the lip more defined. Add another ring cut in the bottom section, then drag it down to almost the bottom. Add one more inside and drag it down into the bottom. Turn off the Selection Limiter again. This will save a mistake later. The mug is done. Let's add colour. Click on this button, then click on the white box in the diffuse section. Choose a nice colour. Then increase the hardness to around 500 in the specular section. It's best to save before the next step. Press Ctrl S or choose Save from the menu. Enter a name and click on Save Blend File. Hit F12 to render your mug. It's a little small. Click on the camera icon and increase the resolution to around 60%. Scroll down and deselect shadows also. Hit F12 again. It looks nicer, but needs more light. Zoom out and select one of the lamps. Hit Shift D to copy it and place it there, and another one there. Change back to side view. You may need to drag them up a little also. Hit F12 again. Much better. Let's animate it. Press I and choose Rotation from the pop-up. Click on frame 25. Then hit R, Z, 90. This will rotate the cup 90 degrees. Hit I and choose a rotation from the pop-up again. Do the same for frames 50, 75 and 100. Hit play, and your mug will now rotate through 360 degrees once. To make this repeat, change to the animation layout at the top of the screen. Under the F-curve editor, click on the down arrow next to action and pick the Z-axis. While in the graph window, hit Ctrl-Shift-M and choose Cycles from the pop-up. If you zoom out the graph, you'll now see zigzags. Hit Shift-T and choose Linear from the pop-up. This will smooth out the rotation. Change back to the default view. As a finishing touch, let's make our handle look more realistic. Tab into Edit Mode, switch to Side View with Keypad 3. Press B to box select this section and drag it up. Hit A, then box select this section and drag it down. Round off the corners by box selecting and then grabbing these vertices and moving them in. Add a loop cut here, then pull the section out a wee bit. And we're done. Let's render our animation. Click on the camera and scroll the box down. Change the file type to QuickTime and give the file a location and a name. Scroll back up and change the resolution to 100%. Then hit Animation. This will render your animation frame by frame. This will take quite some time. And here are the results. For more video information, tutorials, and reviews, head to www.viewfinder.net.nz.